Hello, good morning students. See, in the last lecture, we have started one new lesson, and that lesson name is Convention and Play. Okay, so in this lesson, in the last lecture, we have discussed about the convention means what, okay, and combustible substance. So which substances are combustible, which substances are non-combustible. So for example, in a combustible substance, what is the example? Combustible substance means what? Which burn, okay? And non-combustible substance means which do not burn, for example, steel and etc. Okay, so these some examples we have learned in the last lecture. So today in this lecture, the next point, that is types of combustion. So this we will learn, okay? So now see, the types of combustion. Now you know that the combustions are there. The substances are with the support of any another external material. Then some substances are like that which take a lot of time to burn. Okay, and some substance when they burn, it produce a sound and light. Okay, and these are the some substances where the burning. So according to that, there are main three types of the combustion. Okay, so the first type of combustion, that is a rapid combustion. Second type of combustion, that is a spontaneous combustion. And third type of combustion, that is a explosion. See here, means you will get the idea why the name of the type of combustion. See, rapid combustion. Now rapid means what? Rapid means fast. So in these type of combustion, which a combustible substance will come, those burn very fast, rapid. Okay, so this rapid combustion, rapid combustion means very fast. The spontaneous combustion, it also fast only, but it does not need a support of external support of any another material to burn. Okay, but in the rapid combustion, it need a external support, and then that particular substance start burning. We will see some examples, and then see the explosion. So when any substance burn, the chemical reactions occur, and it immediately blast. Okay, so that type of combustion is known as a explosion. So now in detail, one by one type of combustion we will learn. Okay, so see, in the first type of combustion, that is a rapid combustion. See here, I have written a definition. So after this break, you just write down or whatever the points I have written on the blackboard. So see, when a combustible substance burn at a rapid rate. Okay, see, when a combustible substance burn at a rapid rate. Rapid rate means what? Very fast. Producing a very large amount of heat and light in a short period of time. Okay, means these substances burn very fast and they produce heat and light in a short period of time. But in this rapid combustion, to burn any substance, they need a external support for burning. For example, now you know gas stove, okay? So when we will on that gas stove, so for matchstick or lighter, we need to burn it. Or some gas stoves are aromatic also, okay? So, and see, when you spark that lighter, immediately catch a fire. So this is a rapid rate, okay? So this type of combustion is known as a rapid combustion. See here, some pictures also I have shown you how the means gas stove burn very fastly, okay? And one more, that is a cooking gas start burning immediately. This is one example of a rapid combustion. Then see a burning candle. Now candle, it's burn automatically? No, it need another external support to burn. So we are using a matchstick. Okay, so in this rapid combustion, the combustible substance burn rapidly, but they need a external support to burn. This is very important. Understood? And for example, cooking gas or then candle, these also burn rapidly, but it need external support to burn. Now see, the second type of combustion, that is a spontaneous combustion. Now spontaneous combustion means what? In these type of combustion, what happened? The combustible substance burn automatically, okay? Means when it come contact with the air. Now, as everyone you know that for burning, the most important thing, that is oxygen, is very essential. If oxygen is not present, and any substance will not burn, okay? So, when in these, the combustible substance come contact with air, and in air you know that oxygen is present. So with help of that oxygen, it start burning. It does not need any external support. Means now see, in this rapid combustion, for the cooking gas, for this we need a lighter, okay, matchstick. For candle also we need a matchstick. So but in this spontaneous combustion, it does not need any external support. Now see here, I have written the definition, that is when a combustible substance burn on its own. See, this is very important. When a combustible substance, now everyone you know about what is a combustible substance. So when a combustible substance burn on its own, means it does not need any another external material to burn it, okay? So on its own, without the help of any external heat, it is called as a spontaneous combustion. Do you understand it? Spontaneous combustion means what? See, in this type of combustion, the combustible substance burn on its own, okay? And without the help of any external heat. See, in a rapid combustion, it need the help of external heat, that is a matchbox or lighter, to burn this gas stove. But in this type of combustion, the combustible substance burn by its own. Now, which are the substances which burn by its own? So here see, for example, a white phosphorus. Okay, phosphorus, do you know? This is one the element, okay? So white phosphorus is burn itself without any external support, okay? So when this white phosphorus, if you will get open, it come contact with oxygen and it start burning. See here picture, I have shown you how this white phosphorus is start burning without any external support. So this is the example of spontaneous combustion, as well as one more, that is a forest fire. See, forest fire, sometimes we have seen also, maybe you have observed that. So this is also the spontaneous combustion. It does not need any external heat. When now how this happened, because of the friction and then heat is released, and then the this fire forest, okay? So these are the examples of a spontaneous combustion. So what is the difference in these two types of combustion? See, this is a rapid combustion, means it is very fast, okay? But in this rapid combustion, the combustible substance need external heat, okay? So for example, cooking gas, and to start this cooking gas, we need the matchstick or we need a lighter. And you will say, no madam, only just when we will on that automatic gas stove, then it start burning, but inside also the lighter is fit enough, okay? So these examples of rapid combustion and spontaneous combustion, what happened? It is also very fast process, but it burns itself without the help of any external heat, okay? So these are the two types of combustion. Now we will see the next third one type, that is for explosion. Now see the explosion, do you know the meaning of explosion? So you will get the idea it is which type of a combustion. Now see, the combustion reaction that occurs suddenly with the evolution of a large amount of gas and heat, light and sound is called as a explosion. See, this explosion in some combustible substance, when they start a burning, okay, so they produce a large amount of gas as well as light as well as sound. Now see, in front of us immediately one picture comes, and that is a firecrackers. Okay, so this firecrackers is example of explosion. See, when this firecrackers start burning, then what it produce? A large light as well as the sound, okay, and of gases also. And that gases, you know that it's harmful for us. Okay, so this is the type of explosion, okay, combustion reaction that occurs suddenly when the evaporation of large amount of gases, heat and light and sound is called as a explosion. Okay, so these are the three types of combustion. So maybe you have understood. See this again, we will see one rapid revision building. Now rapid word I am using here, rapid means what? Fast. So today what we have learned, that is the types of combustion. So first type is rapid combustion, second type is spontaneous combustion, third type is explosion. Okay, so in rapid combustion, the combustible substance burns at a rapid rate, means very fast, but they need external support to burn it. Okay, and for example, cooking gas, candle, etc. Then second type, it is a spontaneous combustion. In this combustible substance burn its own, okay, and without the help of any external heat, it is called as a spontaneous combustion. For example, burning of white phosphorus and forest fire. And the third type is, that is a explosion. So combustion reaction that occurs suddenly with the evaporation of large amount of gases, heat, light and sound. So this type of combustion is known as a explosion. So today we have learned the types of combustion. Now homework is for you, that is you write down this all the points in your chemistry notebook, as well as I have given only some examples of rapid combustion, spontaneous combustion and explosion. You have to write more examples. Okay, so now I will stop here. Next point we will continue in our next lecture. Thank you.